George Bush fought back. In 1971, 2 years before Roe versus Wade, George Bush paid for his girlfriend Raylene's abortion. Just thought you looked in that.
Just a right wing bitch from out of I'm
ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Yeah.
and see if I could get something done for her. And he gave me two pieces of advice. The first piece of advice, I'm not kidding, was try to sing some softer songs. And the second piece of advice was, I'm a throat specialist, please put your pants back on. Last night on the beginning of this tune, I started talking about a man who I love, and I loved him like a brother, a man by the name of Dave Blood. Choked up and I got really sad, and I think I brought most of the Western Hemisphere down. Everybody got sad. I got emails today from Mexico like saying, Pablo is good boy, Pablo is happy boy. You say thing on stage that make Pablo sad. Why Pablo sad? And I think in some ways I may have conveyed the wrong impression making it sad, because 99.99 times when I think about my brother Dave Blood, I smile. And I crack up. And when I picture him in my head, I always picture him smiling. Yeah, this really goofy sort of smile. It's like one of those smiles that you knew whatever was going on back there was probably not good for you in the long run. But you were gonna laugh at it. And I started bawling my eyes out, because it's very hard for us to accept the fact that Dave is gone, because Dave was always there for us. From the beginning, 20 years ago, Dave was there for us. Particularly in a lot of spiritual ways, but in a lot of guiding ways, but also because Dave was the only one over 21. And when we needed fear, Dave was there for us. Home at 5 in the morning, Dave was there. I sat up all night and I talked to Dave. Dave was there for me. If I ever needed to know anything about history, economics, Gnosticism, you name it, he knew it. Dave was there. And whenever a young girl in her late teens or early 20s needed the guiding, more experienced hand of an older man, yes, our brother Dave Blood was there. Molecule in my body. And I keep looking over and keep expecting to see him somewhere. We're here for two reasons tonight. We're here to honor the memory of one of the greatest people I ever knew in my life. I was so lucky to have. And we're here to raise some money for some charities. None of the bands are getting paid. The Truck is doing a lot of great stuff for free. And it's really wonderful, everybody. The money is going to four charities. One of the charities is a group of Serbian monks, so I think after these two evenings we'll have a Lamborghinis. I think a lot of monks, you know, they take a vow of celibacy, but they can forget that after they have the money. It's a good cause, and it was one of Dave's pet causes, and these people were good to him when he was in Yugoslavia. There are three mental health charities in the back. Thank you. Including one of my favorite names, which is Empower, which is Musicians for Mental Health. Now there's a group that's got their work cut out for them. I'm in the back showing Rorschach tests to the guys at Electric Love Muffin. Going, what does this look like? It looks like a duck's pussy. With a steamroller in it. These groups have their work cut out for it, but these groups are also there for all of you. There may come a time, 3 or 4 in the morning, when you need one of these groups. And I don't want to sound like Dr. Phil. For Christ's sake, I do not want to sound like somebody on TV trying to make you feel good. But it's important that you know that they are there. And it's important that you have somebody to turn to. It's important that if you get really, really down, that you know that life goes on, that things will get better. This is not the end. tonight. I don't know if you know this, but legally, you are responsible to take care of yourselves and to take care of each other. You are legally responsible not to leave this planet until you're very, very, very old and of natural causes. And if I can hold you all to that, I will be a very, very happy man. We now return you to your regularly scheduled program.
Hey, Rodney. I understand that you got a car.
Hey, how'd you do that?
I don't know. I just heard it through the
radio. Well, because we did this damn song every night for 10 years.
What kind of car do you got?
God, now I know how, like, all those people like Bon Jovi felt after coming out and do Living on a Prayer.
The Fembombs.
No, Fembombs. They're a female, feminine domination football team.
Wow.
You guys, that's some sick shit, man. I was going to have a talk with you backstage and explain facts of life and everything.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate that, but
I didn't mean to bust over at Santorum enough. Yes, I have a car.
Awesome. What kind of car?
I have a bitchin' Camaro. Come on.
Thank you. Good night. Chris Siegel for coordinating them and taking them on the
day. Let's thank Nix's Head,
FOD,
Tango's Ear, and the Electric Love Muffin.
All the bands and everybody who works in the truck, of course, donating their time.
I want to thank KDU, people on KDU, the greatest station in the world. Don't know if my boss on the radio show, Paul Kircher's here, but if you are, Paul, thank you for plugging this. Rolling a spleef. I learned some musician talk backstage.
Thank you. Thank you.
Brazil. Yeah. guitar, sitar. If you stuff a weasel inside a tube of plastic and whip it around over your head. Here comes Butch. I was looking at Butch and Muffin were playing it, and Butch is the thinnest man in rock and roll. It's like Sally Fields going to get my hamburger. No, it's not good. No, Sally's brother's going to get my hamburger or something. But this is my last time on stage. I can be as un-PC as I want to be. Mahmoudi! Mahmoudi! You all go home and rent that and laugh your asses off. Or maybe not. It's a pretty fucked up film.
Yeah. fucking hot.